One day, Tommy Estrada went to the Nike store off Whittier Boulevard in East Los Angeles. As he left with bags of merch, he stepped on a flat sundial shape about the size of a manhole on the sidewalk, not realizing he was treading on East Lowe's royalty. Beneath his feet was a red granite monument for Edward James Olmos, star of Stand and Deliver, Zoot Suit, and so many other hallmarks of Chicano cinematic life. It was one of about 10 such markers on the legendary street that make up the Latino Walk of Fame, a monument created to highlight Latinos who have made East Los Angeles proud. Estrada didn't have a clue. "Man, I didn't even notice," the 29-year-old said apologetically. "It's my bad. People don't really look down where they walk, I guess." Up and down Whittier Boulevard, pedestrians ignored the Walk of Fame at best, but usually inadvertently strolled all over honorees. Middle-aged men stood on Cesar Chavez's plaque while they waited for a bus. Hungry diners skipped on the one outside a Wingstop dedicated to Mexican singer Graciela Beltran. A man flicked his spent cigarette on the sundial for Romana Acosta Bañuelos, the first ever Latina to serve as U.S. Treasurer. "I always wondered what they were," said Hortensia Delgado, 48. She was in front of an outlet store, next to a sundial for longtime Eastside Congressman Ed Roybal. "It's a nice idea, but maybe there should be more promotion? I always thought it's a little tacky for this to be happening," admitted Antonio Mejia Rentes, who recently wrote an essay about the Walk of Fame for East LA Weekly. "This is a good way to commemorate people from the community that had done well. This wasn't the way anyone had envisioned this working out back in 1984. That's when the Whittier Boulevard Merchants Association successfully asked the state and Los Angeles County for $1.5 million to beautify the mile of road between Arizona and Atlantic Avenues. The funds paid for the now iconic Whittier Boulevard arch, and for more than 250 slots cut on the street's sidewalks in anticipation of a who's who of beautiful sundials to honor celebrities, activists, and hometown heroes. But the first one, for the Whittier Boulevard Merchants Association, didn't pop up until 1997. And let's face it, the Whittier Boulevard Merchants Association doesn't have the same ring to it as Antonio Aguilar, who didn't receive his sundial until 2007. Which is to say, no one is going to take a selfie doing the old thumbs up sign in front of the AGUAN. The few others installed in the years since are now faded and smudged and placed scattershot. The empty slots, currently filled with rubber and a geometric Aztec motif, await a true Walk of Fame that may never come. This Latino Walk of Fame pales in comparison to similar ambulatory efforts in Southern California, like the Promenade of Prominence in Watts for Black Icons and Palm Springs Walk of Stars.